This is Carl with Future Achievers, and I am back with another inspirational interview. In this video, I sit down with Mr. Julian Short of Short Films. Julian talks about the grind, just the everyday hustle that he's having to use in order to get himself to where he wants to be and to accomplish his goals. This has been an inspiring conversation for me, and I hope it inspires you all too. For more videos like this, check out our YouTube channel, follow us on social media. Also, go to our website at futureachievers.org. Email us at info@futureachievers.org. Let's go. All right, man, let's jump into this. Mr. Julian Short of Short Films. I appreciate having you here today for Future Achievers, just another inspirational conversation. Know about you a little bit just from seeing your films online. Social media, reached out to you. We've had some conversations here and there, and I'm inspired by what you're doing and how you're doing it, man. And I want to bring you to the people and have you share your story. So I appreciate you sharing this time with us today.
Thank you. Appreciate you. Always. Yeah.
Let's start at the beginning, man. How'd you get started? In film, in photography, like where'd this passion come from?
Honestly, I've always had it, but just haven't noticed it until recent. I want to say back in about a year ago, last February, I was having a conversation with a teammate, Jalen McKay, and a lady who works at IUEC Campus Life, Amanda Vance, and just talking about how, you know, a lot of Division I schools have all this media. They have all these, you know, these photos, these videos, these things that kind of like hype them up and, you know, make them look, you know, pretty good. And it helps them as far as, you know, a fan base, as far as recruiting, as far as the school in general. And for us as IUEs, you know, being a good program and, you know, just having a good history, you know, going to the national tournament a few years in a row, making it to the Final Four, Elite Eight, and so on and so forth. I just wanted to figure out a way where we can do that. And I'm like, you know, how come we can't do the same thing? A lot of these schools are doing it, Division I, regardless. I'm sure there's a way we can do the exact same thing. We have a photographer that comes every now and then, but it's not in depth. You don't see the life of these players. You don't see, you know, how these players move around the school, around campus, you know what I mean? So it was a thought. It was only a thought. And I said, you know what, I'm going to actually, you know, invest and try to, you know, get a camera and see what I can do. But that was in February when I was actually still in season and still in school. So February, March came, we made it to the national tournament, we won conference, we got to South Dakota, and when we got there, we practiced, we had walked through the day of our game that morning, and our season got canceled because of COVID, and so that was my senior season, that was my last year, and even though I wasn't, let's put it in, you know, I wasn't a major piece, I wasn't scoring 30 or scoring, you know, getting 20 rebounds a game. But at the same token, I was doing something and I was, you know, that's what I've been doing almost my whole life, was playing basketball. And for my senior season to end that fast, it was more so like, man, that's it. You know what I mean? So you don't think about, you know, your season ending like that. You think about maybe an injury or maybe something happening, but you don't think about the season ending like that. And so once that happened, we all got sent home and I literally sat at the house. This is during quarantine when it first happened during lockdown. And I sat in the house and literally studied and tried to figure out what I wanted to do. I'm like, I'm about to graduate in May. What's going to happen? Like, I got to figure out a career. I'm getting a psychology degree. I'm not really fond of school like that. And I know I have to go a little bit further for, you know, a degree. And so if I want to work somewhere in a good path where I'm making good money, I got to go a little bit further in my education. So I just, you know, with my history with transferring and injuries and going to all these different schools and being 26, I said, no, I think school right now, I think once I get this degree, I'm going to take a break. And so I had to think of something that I wanted to do for myself.
What do you want to do with film? Like what's your passion kind of specifically there? Is it sports related? Is it more, what is it?
My passion obviously is sports, right? I've been in sports my entire life, football in high school and basketball. And then basketball all the way through college. So sports is kind of, that's always going to be with me. And so being able to take these moments, right? That's my whole entire thing is moments. I feel like as an individual with my family, I don't have many photos of me when I was younger or many photos of me when with my family, or we don't have much of that. And so to kind of talk about, you know, moments, that's the things that, you know, we always want to remember, you know, no matter, you know, it might be that dunk on someone, that moment, or it might be that proposal, that moment. Those are things that are huge in people's lives that I want to impact. And so sports, obviously, that's something that I love doing. But as I, once I started and kind of just got into doing different things, different lanes, I didn't want to short myself or limit myself. So I was like, hey, whatever comes, I'll learn how to do it and become good at it. And so I think I took that mindset from being an athlete and just transitioned that mindset to being an adult. Not saying I wasn't an adult in college, but being on your own and taking care of yourself and doing all these things, that mindset was still, you know, taken with me. So being able to, you know, take these moments from different angles, literally angles, and being able to impact people and show others who are maybe going through the exact same thing and being able to say, you know what, I can relate to that. And I always thought that I was going through that, but I thought it was just me. But now I can see that he's going through it, she's going through it, they're going through it. It's more so, it's more impactful. And now they can, you know, the anxiety, the depression and all that can kind of just go down to a minimum almost, just because they can see other people are going through the same thing. So that's really it. I just really, I'm really passionate about helping others. I mean, I have a psychology degree, so being able to help others is always something that I wanted to do. So kind of using my psych background and taking my creative background and putting it all in one, being able to, hey, you know, I'm able to help this person out, or, you know, send a message out to everybody else. And so this upcoming month, I'm really excited for, because I have a few different projects that I want to acknowledge a fair amount of people. And I think that would help me and also help others in the long run, because I'm more so focused on helping other people. The money comes, but I don't chase it. I mean, that's not the main purpose. I feel like if you do it the right way and you do it with passion and you do it with hard work, it all comes. But for me, I'm so passionate about helping everybody. And I think sometimes it's almost a gift and a curse. But I was always talking, you know, when you give, you know, it comes back. It comes back. So that's what I do. That's what I do. I just try to give and stay positive. And I know being positive is not always easy, especially in today's world. So being positive is something that I kind of recreate every day. I try to force it and show it every day so people can see it. It's like, okay, well, he might not be going through the best times, but he's still taking the positives out of it. Just like COVID. I mean, COVID, when it first happened, everyone was like, man, I can't do this, I can't do that. And I feel like COVID was the best time for me in my life. And I know that's kind of a bad way to put it, but as far as teaching lessons and being able to take adversity and, you know, change it into a positive. And that's what I've done all my life when it comes to basketball, with injuries and transfers and scholarships being taken and things like that. Just use that. Like COVID was another situation, another one added to every other situation that I've had. And so I was able to do the exact same thing.
Yeah, absolutely. And definitely don't want to play light or take COVID lightly, because, you know, not trying to do that at all. I mean, my family's been impacted as well. And so I know some of what it can do firsthand. But at the same time, I think, man, in hearing you, I hear it. And in talking with others, I hear it as well, too. Sometimes we got to take, you know, the good with the bad. Like, we got to take a bad situation and figure out how to flip it and make it work, you know, for us, or take some of the lessons from it, right? And use it to help propel us forward. Because, I mean, the world never stopped. I mean, it felt like it did.
Right.
You know, but things had to get done. Bills had to get paid. You were graduating soon and you had to figure out, what am I going to do next? Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, you definitely gotta keep moving. Mm-hmm. Man. So I like when you talk about, too, you know, not chasing the money. Right. Mm-hmm. And then you can definitely hear in the things that you're interested in, the things that you're capturing with your lens, that like you said, your psychology background. And that interest and passion coming together with your photography as well, too. You know, who are some people that you've worked with, you know, to date? What are some memories that you have from filming?
I have a few. Just being able to, first and foremost, take those moments that I talked about in February. Being able to say, you know, I want our school to be the exact same way. And so this past year, I know it was short due to the cancellation of the IU East men's basketball season this year again. I was able to do that for them, take photos, videos, post on their social medias. And, you know, that was something that I dreamt of or, you know, had in my mind last February. So I kind of brought it into fruition, you know what I mean? So that was a great moment for me just because I was able to make people happy. And the players loved it. The players were excited about it. And just being able to think, okay, what if I was in their shoes? Like, I would love to have this, you know what I mean? So just being able to do that for them, that was something impactful. Working with Terrence Hall this past, for a few projects. He's been one of a big supporter of mine. Just being able to do a lot of those projects, you know, with the Black Fathers.
So what's a Black Father to you, man?
I mean, really, it's the same universally. Like, I feel like there's something in all of us, Black, white, you know, any father, man, they're going to love their children more than anything, you know. That's the beautiful thing about fatherhood is that it transcends race. You know, we can all take from each other, learn from each other, and grow in that way.
Man, there's a lot. There's a lot of different memories. Just being able to go back to Chicago and take photos of people that I went to school with, who I was, you know, I wasn't as close with, but now they're like, hey, you know, you're pretty good. Let's do this and do that. And so as we're taking these photos, I'm having these conversations with them about, you know, life. And it was, you know, these were not just photos in my eyes. When you see these photos, to you, you're like, oh, these are great photos. But to me, these were conversations. These were, you know, things that built up throughout this session that just, you know, that helped me impact my life and theirs. And so it's more than just a photo shoot in my eyes to me.
Yeah.
And so just doing, you know, all these different things that I'm doing here, the impact that I made in Richmond, being able to, the documentary of Desmond Bane, like that was something that I didn't expect. I didn't expect it at all, but the turnaround was, I think we started shooting. He got here on a Sunday night. We started shooting Monday, Tuesday. The draft was on a Wednesday and the video came out Thursday night. I think the turnaround for that was crazy. And I didn't think I could do it, but I did it. And so now looking back on, I watch it every now and then to kind of, you know, get some ideas and try to fix things. And there are some things that I, you know, obviously you always want to be your biggest critic, right? And so I see that all the time and want to fix certain things for the future. But I think that was one of my biggest moments, being able to do that for him and just seeing, you know, that the first video I put on my YouTube was like 248 views or something. That was when I did the, during the Black Lives Matter movement, when it talked about the business owners, the Black business owners. And I went around and grabbed about five or six of them. Yeah. And that was at 248 views. And then I did it, the Black Fathers, we went to like 700, 800 views. And then I did the Desmond Bane video, which got to 5,000 views. So seeing that jump from 200 to 5,000, I mean, it's not a million, but I mean, that's a huge jump, a huge difference. And so, you know, during basketball season, we always talked about being better 1% each day, you know, adding a 1% every day. And so I take that same mindset when it comes to my videos and my photography. Get better at least 1% each day. Do not get worse and do not plateau. You know what I mean? And because if you plateau, then, you know, someone can pass you up easily.
the be better 1% each day. I like that because, so let me just put this out here. I mean, I I'm not, you know, making fun or anything like this, but mm-hmm. but you're not living, you know, a lavish lifestyle. You're not a millionaire yet. Mm-hmm. You're not balling out of control. Right. I mean, it's a process, mm-hmm. though. I know you're doing your photography and your film, but you also, you know, are holding down another job as well too. You know, to make ends meet. So it's, I mean, it's a grind. I mean, it's not, you haven't arrived yet. It's not easy. The work, you know, you still got to continue to put that in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it doesn't happen overnight. I mean, there is a process through all of this. And I think, you know, again, basketball, I hate to use it all the time, but basketball was more than just a sport. It taught, you know, life lessons. And so, you know, with this, you know, it's every day is a grind. You know what I mean? I get up every day, you know, I work out in the mornings and then, you know, I might have a shoot or some editing or something throughout the day. And then I go to work at Roadhouse at 4 o'clock and serve until about 9:30. And so that's, that's pretty much how my life is every day. But I don't complain about it. I don't get upset about it. Yeah. I understand how things go. I understand how life is. Having a single parent mom with twin boys and an older sister, being able to make ends meet like that, I understand what it takes. And so as long as you're not comfortable, and as long as you don't want to, we all want to be in a different zone. We all want to be somewhere different, right? But there's actions you have to take, and you can't be satisfied with anything. And I'm nowhere near satisfied with my work. I'm nowhere near satisfied with what I'm doing. So every day and every week and every month, there is an improvement. There is something that I want to accomplish. And so I'm definitely excited about this February, because I have a few different projects that I think that will be very impactful. But my plan is to try to work somewhere where I can do what I love doing. Within, you know, I want to this summer, you know, I don't want to short myself either. So like this summer is a huge summer for me. So spring and now into spring, I have to work hard to get to that point. And so, you know, working at Roadhouse, I have to do that and do what I'm doing now in order to get that accomplished.
Where do you see yourself going after this?
I just want to be able to do something consistent. I know different projects for different companies is okay. It's fine. I like that. But I want to be able to do something more consistent where I know, okay, I will receive this paycheck every weekend or every other week or whatever salary, because I have a life to live. I have bills to pay and things like that. And so not being greedy, not just saying, you know, I deserve it and I'm the best. No, I'm humble about what I'm doing. There's always work that can be done, and there's always improvements that can be done as well. So just being able to go somewhere, Florida, but okay. I went there two times in the past 2 months, and it was great down there. So
yeah. And you want to continue in film?
Yes.
Is that the goal?
I want to continue in film. Film is, okay. The more I do it, the more I love it. And at first it was photography, then it was sports photography, but now it's more so sports photography, sports films, documentaries, that area.
Okay.
And so just being able to recreate and talk about someone's story, because we all have stories.
Right.
Being able to talk about stories and have people just like, man, I want to inspire other people. So when they finish watching that documentary or that video, they want to get up, either work out, find a job, or, you know, do those things where it helps their life. And so that's for me. That's the plan for me, to keep doing what I'm doing. Putting together a reel at the end of the month. So kind of like a combination of all the projects that I did this month, and, you know, a few in the past as well. But just a reel to kind of show who I am and exactly exemplify my work and my creativity as well. And so I want people to see that. And that's kind of like a resume for me as well, for other companies to see, okay, this is what he can do and this is who he is. So the plan is to be done with that by the beginning of March and get that out throughout March and April and May, and hopefully hear something June, July, August. And that's the plan for me.
Okay. So, and this is a business that you created. So, I mean, what are some things that you're doing, you know, to keep yourself out there, to connect with others, to drum up business for yourself? Like, what's that process look like?
So it's a pretty, you gotta, with that process, you kind of like gotta swallow your pride, because you want to make money, obviously. But, you know, sometimes like in the beginning, you gotta do a lot of free work. And so, sometimes I go to these games, these high school games around the city, and I just show up with my camera, take pictures, and I use that to kind of show, okay, this is what I can do. And so then a lot of parents reach out afterwards. There's a lot of different shoots that I'm starting to do. I just did a boudoir shoot a few days ago, and that was my first one. And so now I have people, you know, reaching out to do more of those. And so I think just being able to be to accept more and just be creative with just different things. Like, there are so many different ways to be creative, and art is a huge platform to just do what you feel and do what you want. And being able to do that, I think it just creates more opportunities, and being different creates a lot more opportunities, or unique. And so that's what I'm doing. Just going out, just doing random projects, random videos, just posting them and just trying to just be more creative every time. And eventually, a lot of different people will reach out, and that's what I've been getting for the past few months. So it's a blessing. It's a blessing. I'm just taking it all in and being humble about it, and just knowing that, you know, taking advantage of it because it can all go within a second, just like how my season did during COVID. So that's how I think about it every day.
And I hope that's one takeaway, you know, that somebody watching this, this conversation walks away with, is just go do it. Mm-hmm. Right. I mean, we got dreams and goals and hopes. It's like, go get it done. Mm-hmm. Why are you sitting around waiting for the perfect time or for the perfect this or the perfect? There is no perfect time.
Right.
You know,
right.
Just start taking steps, go put in the work, and things will come. You know, yep. People will come, connections, networking is going to happen, information and knowledge is going to come. I mean, I'm just, man, there's just so much information on the internet right now. I mean, you can do just about anything. You can definitely be a novice, you know, with the information out there, but it's enough to get you started, you mm-hmm. know, and then to get you to the next place after that and the next place after that, you know, the people and the information will come to you to keep pushing you forward.
Definitely.
But the first step is just get out there and go do it.
Yep. And that's what I had to do in April. I was just sat around and during COVID and hit up a guy that I knew from out here, Dakota Pennington, who was really, his work is really good. And I hit him up and said, hey, I want to learn about this camera. I want to learn about photography and videography. And he was able to help me with certain things. He sold me my first camera. Once I got the camera, I did a few little shoots every now and then just to kind of get it out there for free, obviously. And then I was doing photo editing on Photoshop with different athletes and selling those and just kind of just getting out there. And then saved up and got this good lens for sports photography specifically. And once I got that lens, that's when I used it for IUE's men's basketball and just took it, you know, from there. And then once I did that, I just everything just started to come. Everything just started to come in fruition. Just took it slow. And then everything that I got, I just put it towards my equipment, put everything towards my equipment. And sometimes it's not just about the equipment. It's also about who's behind it as well. So, yes, equipment helps, but if you don't know what you're doing with it, then it's like, okay, this is still trash. So, but I still try to, I was just busy. I was just working and knew it'd come. And it was a process, and it was an investment, a major investment within yourself. And you have to believe in that in order for things to kind of come out. And so it was a quick turnaround. I was like, you know what? Forget it. I'll do it. And so I was just putting money into myself, and I was late on some bills, and I was like, it'll come back. And so I was able to get bills done. And then, you know, it was just a process. And so now I'm here with doing what I'm doing, and still investing. And it will come back eventually. So just staying humble and just being happy with everything that I'm doing, and just want to spread positivity.
Yeah, I was about to say that. You mentioned that before, being humble, man. And I'll say too, you know, being very approachable. And definitely you are. I think I saw one of your films online. And I'm like, man, that's hot. Like I gotta talk to this guy and see if we can, you know, figure out a way to do some work together and some different things, man. I was just able to reach out to you. And I said, man, can we meet? Can we talk? He was like, absolutely.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, and so I think, you know, that will bring people to you as well, having that good attitude, putting that good energy out there, being willing to sit down and talk with folks and just see where conversations, you know, will take you and what doors they'll open up for you.
For sure. Yeah. Sure.
So let me ask you this, man, how do you keep going? How do you, what keeps you moving forward? Cause definitely there's gotta be, you know, you talked about having to do some work for free early on. You know, you're talking about you're working towards getting that steady paycheck. So, I mean, I'm sure probably there's times where things fall through. Maybe you had an appointment scheduled, but they got to reschedule or something like that. Like, how do you, cause I know for me, and I'm sure for others, sometimes those things will kind of cause you to doubt yourself maybe, or to think, man, did I make the right decision? You know, I can't pay this bill right now. And I'm out here trying to follow my dreams, but my dreams don't seem to be, you know, raking in the dough like I wanted to. Like, how do you keep from getting knocked off your path?
Just seeing myself get to a point that I didn't think I could get to this fast. I'll put it that way, this fast. I know that I can get to a point, and I know I haven't reached my point, but seeing myself just gradually improving, gradually seeing people and just going places and people noticing my work, like I feel like that's huge. Like I'm not saying I'm famous or anything. That's not what I'm saying at all. But when people notice your work, like that's huge. Like that's not like It's like, you know, being noticed as a basketball player almost. Like, I keep comparing it, but it's kind of like that was my transition. I feel like we're here. We all think we have a we have something we're put on this earth to do. And at first, I was like, okay, I want to play basketball. That was my thing. And then obviously, I started to see, like, okay, this is not it. And so now it's kind of see, I'm starting to see, like, that same thought process, that same, those same access that I thought I would have through basketball, I'm having it through this. And so just seeing people reach out, the amount of people reach out, that they increase every day. Everything increases every day. And as long as I see an increase, I can't doubt myself. As long as I see that I'm able to get things done, I can't doubt myself. I've been through many situations before, and I keep saying that. But just, you know, quick story, just being able to, you know, I've transferred four times. I've been to four different schools. Went to a junior college for 2 years, got my scholarship taken. Went to St. Francis University in Fort Wayne, got hurt, got my scholarship taken after the first semester. Then went home, worked for a semester at a job downtown Chicago. Then went to Governor State and got another scholarship, but got that taken for a different situation. Finally, I started working again, and then I was, there was a guy who went here, IU East, that I knew, who went to St. Francis, Charles Peterson, and he was able to talk to my coach here, who wanted me to come on a visit and things like that, and, you know, he liked me, and everything just worked out. And so once I got here, I also had a situation, just being able to live on my own, pay my own rent, pay my own phone bill. Like, I was an adult, literally living in and going to school and playing basketball. So all those different situations kind of just proved to me that I can get through anything. You know what I mean? I was able to overcome all those times. Like, I feel like any person, if they get their scholarship taken one time, they're done.
Yeah.
Second time, they're definitely done. A third time, come on. Like, so I was able to keep going, regardless of, you know, my body, obviously with injuries, it just, I was able to maintain as much as I could, but I was still able to get my degree. And so I have an IU degree that not a lot of people can say they did that. And so absolutely, that right there within a, what's that, 2013 all the way to 2021, that time span was just nothing but adversity for me. Being able to overcome all that adversity, and then I just take that and transition that with photography. Like, there's going to be things that come with this. There's a business. There's going to be people that like you. There's going to be people who dislike you. There's going to be people who like your work. There's going to be people who don't like your work, but that comes with this. So being able to understand what comes with it, it's just like being, just like working at a, you know, a job, and, you know, you're just upset because people are yelling at you. Well, that comes with that, because this, that's what you signed up for. And so being able to take that in and understand, this is what I signed up for. I can't doubt myself. This is what it is. Improve, learn as much as you can, write it down, and don't settle. Don't settle. Want to learn something new every day with this. And that's what I'm doing. And so as long as that keeps happening, I'll be fine. I'll be fine. I can't doubt myself at all.
Absolutely. Absolutely, man. I love it, man. I love it. Hey, where can people find your work?
So if you Facebook my name, Julian Short, J-U-L-I-A-N, Short, S-H-O-R-T. All my work is on there. Instagram, at Julian Short with 3 underscores at the end. And then Twitter, I might put a few things on there, but that's J_Short1. I'm working on a website that should be done this week, actually. Working on a website. But once that's complete, then that'll be on my social media as well. So that's why my work is. Excited to put more up, and, you know, just excited for the month, honestly.
Okay, good. You got YouTube as well?
Yes. Sorry. YouTube, Short Films Photography, or it might be Julian Short. It might be Julian Short YouTube or Short Films Photography. Either one of those two, it'll pop up.
And always taking on more work?
Yeah, always. Always. Okay. Always. Just taking on more. Man, you see my calendar right there. It's getting full for the month. And so just being able to, I'm excited. I love doing this. This is something I love doing. Just love hearing people's visions and bringing them to life. I hear a lot of people, they come to me and say, hey, you know, I want this done. This is what I'm visioning. Or I have people say, hey, look, I want this done. You do what you need to do to it. And so, you know, that's what happens. But, you know, either or. So I'm just definitely excited.
Okay. And I've seen you do, again, we know the sports photography, you've done the films there. you did the film on the Black Fathers as well too, which is kind of like a documentary piece, you know, to that. I've seen you do some other photo shoots as well too. I think maybe you did. Did you do maybe like a maternity?
Yep.
Shoot, yeah. So you open to all those?
Open everything. Maternity, videos, sports photography, sports videos, documentaries, boudoir shoots, whatever. Music videos. That's next. That's okay. Next. But I'm open for everything, man. I'm excited.
All right, sounds good. Mr. Julian Short Films, thank you for your time. I appreciate you being here with us.
Always, thank you for having me. It was a pleasure, and I appreciate it as much.
Absolutely, man. Good luck to everything you put your lens to.
Yes, for sure. Appreciate you. I know I can.